Church of Christ presents Back to the Bible.
Let's please go back to the Bible.
Everybody,
let's please go back to the Bible.
Jesus wanna speak.
Welcome once again, viewers, to your religious program on TV, Back to the Bible. This program is sponsored by the Churches of Christ in Akwa Ibom State, and we simply and humbly ask you to go back to the Bible and search the scriptures, especially the pages of the New Testament, for your salvation on matters of faith. Now, this program, like we said, sponsored by Church of Christ, you see the names and addresses of these churches on the screen. And as we be going on, you see some telephone numbers. Please feel very free to send in your questions, your comments, and we'll be glad to respond to you. Now, we have a very simple way of preaching the gospel, and that is telling people to know the truth. Because Jesus Christ said, "You shall search the scriptures, and by so doing you know the truth, and this truth shall set you free." Now, before I introduce the topic for today's discussion, let us as usual go to God in prayers. Our Father and our God in heaven, we thank you once again for this opportunity you've given to us to share your gospel with the viewers. Father, we ask you, Lord, to allow us to speak your word and nothing but your word that would be led by the Holy Spirit, and allow our listeners to search the scriptures after hearing these words, and then at the end put them into practice for the salvation of their souls. Thank you, Father, for hearing our prayers and enable us to do this. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Viewers, you're welcome back. Now, the topic for today's discussion is the misconception about the kingdom. Don't forget that the theme for this quarter had been search the scriptures. And we know that the scriptures have been given by the inspiration of God, and it is profitable unto our own salvation. And that is why we are asking you to search the scriptures and do like the Bereans. After hearing the word of God, they went back to the Bible to search, to find out if what they heard were true or not. And so we want to talk about the misconceptions about the kingdom. Because for the past how many lessons we've been talking about the kingdom of Christ, the kingdom of God. And people have been thinking that if really the kingdom had come, then there will be no problems in the world. There will be no death and all of that. We want to see what the scriptures have to tell us about this, if they are true or not. Now, we want to know that in the scriptures, when Jesus Christ was talking to his apostles, he told them a lot of things about this kingdom. And for one, he told them that they would have to pass through a lot of problems. And like we say, people have this misconception that if the kingdom had come from the prayer of Jesus in Matthew chapter 6, verse 10, then definitely there would be no death. We want to tell us that if what they're saying is true, then that means what Jesus Christ said was untrue. But we want you to note that first person that had something to tell us is Apostle John. Apostle John, a brief background about this man. He was one of the apostles of Jesus Christ, and his brother was James, and they were the sons of Zebedee, and they were always referred to as the sons of thunder. Don't forget that their mother went to Jesus secretly and tried to persuade Jesus, or tried to request from him, that when this kingdom would come, then she would wish that James and John would sit on the right and on the left hand of Jesus in that kingdom. And when Jesus heard this statement, he was not really very happy. Well, he had to tell them that they did not know what they were asking for. They did not know what they were requesting for, because they were thinking that the kingdom was going to be a physical kingdom, not knowing that it was a spiritual kingdom. It was nothing but the church. And so when the other apostles heard about this request of their mother to Jesus, they were really very mad at James and John. But this James is always referred to as John the Beloved. And he is the only apostle of Jesus that died a natural death at old age. Of course, before that happened, he had to be sent away, he had to be banished to the island of Patmos by the Roman government. And so while in the Isles of Patmos, he passed through a lot of problems, he had passed through a lot of tribulations, and so of course they did that because they wanted probably the wild beast to kill him. Now let us hear what he had to say about the kingdom and the suffering or tribulation about or among Christians. In Revelation chapter 1 verse 9, he says, "I, John, who also am your brother and companion in tribulation and in the kingdom and patience of Jesus Christ, was in the isles that is called Patmos for the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus Christ." You see, John here identifies himself as an apostle of Jesus, a brother and a companion in tribulation and in the kingdom. In other words, he was in tribulation in the kingdom because that was the hallmark of every Christian as at that time. Thank God that we're living in an age that we are not persecuted as such. But then again, in some parts of the world, Christians are still persecuted. And so, after having identified himself as a brother and a companion in the kingdom and in tribulation, then that implies definitely that every child of God may have to face one type of tribulation or another. Now, stories shows that all the apostles of Jesus were persecuted and killed. And of course, it's instructive because Jesus did tell them when he sent them or commissioned them to go and preach the gospel to the lordship of the house of Israel, the gospel of the kingdom to the lordship of the house of Israel, in Matthew chapter 10, verse number 7, when he charged them. Now, if you read down some verses, he told them that he had sent them out into the midst of wolves. And we know that wolves don't spare any human being. Even though this statement was used figuratively, yet the message was very clear that they could lose their lives. And so it is instructive that any Christian who worships God today in the church should be prepared to face tribulations. And we just want to see some of these things that the Bible had told us. Now, if you read Matthew 20 verse 20 down, that is when we had the story of the mother of James and John who appeared to Jesus. Now, we want to say that Jesus emphatically told the apostles that they will face these challenges. They will face this tribulation. In Matthew 10, verse number 16 to verse 17, I read, "Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves. But beware of men, for they will deliver you up to the councils, and they will scourge you in their synagogues." Yes, that was the instruction that Jesus Christ gave to them. He emphatically told them that you will be persecuted. So in other words, we know that by so doing, they had to fortify themselves with this truth that they will face a lot of challenges. And in verse 21, it says, "For the brother shall deliver up the brother to death, and the father the child, and the children shall rise up against their parents and cause them to be put to death. And he shall be hated of all men for my name's sake. But he that endureth to the end shall be saved." Yes, this is very true. Every child of God, as at that time, as at the time the kingdom came, which is the church, they faced persecutions. And we, of course, we know that the very first person, the very first martyr was Stephen, who, after he was preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ, the gospel of the kingdom, was persecuted and he was stoned to death. We have this story in Acts chapter 7, beginning from verse 1 down, but from verse 56 down, is when Stephen told the Jews that they had always been persecuting the people of God. And it is no wonder they were persecuting him. And so they stoned him to death. And even while they were stoning him to death, the Bible says he knelt down and prayed to God to forgive them because they did not know what they were doing. So it is instructive here to know that every child of God must face tribulation one way or the other. It could be even in your home. Your parents may hate you, like we had read in that Matthew chapter 10, verse 21 down. You may be hated by your brother. You may be hated by your husband. You may be hated by your wife. So whatever happens, you need to fortify yourself with this truth and know that you have to face these things. It is a part of the calling, right? And so we see here that, like we said, almost all the apostles were persecuted and were killed. Peter, we are told, you know, was nailed to the cross, but upside down. James was beheaded. A lot of them, you know, faced tribulations in one way or the other, and they were stoned to, they were sent to death, or they were killed. Now, when Jesus was telling this statement, he did not mince words. He told them, "If I had suffered, then you would also suffer." And that is why we read in the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse number 1 to verse 4, to tell us, to convince us, that every child of God must be prepared to face tribulations in this life. So long as you are in this kingdom, so long as Christ has not yet come, so long as Christ has not yet sent his angels to gather out of his kingdom things that offend and those that do iniquity, then you must face tribulations in one way or the other. Now, I read in that passage, 1 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 1 to verse 4. "Wherefore, when we could no longer forbear, we thought it good to be left at Athens alone, and sent Timothy, our brother and minister of God, and our fellow laborer in the gospel of Christ, to establish you and to comfort you concerning your faith." Verse 3, "that no man should be moved by these afflictions, for yourself know that we are appointed unto it." We are appointed unto it. In other words, Christians are appointed unto tribulations. Therefore, if somebody preaches to you and tells you that you as a Christian, you should not suffer, you should not face the persecutions here and there, then that person is deceiving you and not telling you the truth of the gospel. And that's why this program, which is sponsored by the Church of Christ, is telling you that you should be fortified with this fact that as a Christian, as a child of God in the kingdom, you must face tribulation one way or the other. And so we now see also that in this life, as a child of God in the kingdom, we must also face undue sufferings. But before I talk that fully, I want you to understand that Jesus did say in Gospel of John chapter 16, verse 33, that we must pass through tribulations to enter into the kingdom of God. What did he mean? That so long as we are in this kingdom, which is the church on earth, we have to pass through tribulations before we get to heaven. Before we get to heaven. And that's why we want you to know this fact, that as a child of God in the kingdom, we must be prepared to suffer tribulations one way or the other. Now I read Gospel of John chapter 16, verse 33. "These things have I spoken unto you, that in me ye might have peace. In the world ye shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world." Yes, Jesus was not joking. He said in the world we're going to have tribulations. Christians are going to have tribulations. His apostles started it. They faced tribulation one way or the other. And so we who are following him would also have to pass through tribulations. And that is why we are telling you, if anybody had been preaching to you and telling you that you should not pass through, or it's not a part of the Christian life to pass through tribulations, then that person had been deceiving you. Therefore, we are asking you, viewers, to know that as a child of God in the kingdom, you must pass through tribulations. And I'll come your way very shortly after this time out.
Friends, let's go back to the Bible.
Jesus wants to speak.
Yeah, welcome back. In continuation of the same statement that was made by Jesus in John chapter 16, verse 33, Apostle Paul had this to say in Acts chapter 14, verse 22. He said, confirming the souls of the disciples and exhorting them to continue in the faith, and that we must through much tribulation enter into the kingdom of God. This was what Paul told the Christians, the early Christians, that we must pass through a lot of tribulations to enter into the kingdom of God. This kingdom of God, you must understand, is heaven. We have to suffer here, but in heaven there is no suffering, there is no death, there is no sickness there. But while here on earth, we have to pass through these things, so long as we are human beings. Now, we were talking about undue sufferings. Yes, the Bible teaches that Christians must necessarily suffer. But he adds a caveat that we should not suffer as evildoers. This is very important. In spite of the fact that it is a part of the Christian faith, a part of the Christian life to suffer, yet we should not suffer as people who are evildoers. And that's why we want to take time to read that passage of 1 Peter and then see what the Holy Spirit tells us, warning us that even though we ought to suffer for Christ, we should not suffer as evildoers. Now, it says verse 13, 1 Peter chapter 4, verse number 13. In fact, let me start from verse 12. It says, behold, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which is to try you, as though some strange thing had happened unto you. But rejoice, inasmuch as you are partakers of Christ's sufferings, that when his glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy. Verse 14, if ye be reproached for the name of Christ, happy are ye, for the Spirit of glory and of God rest upon you. And on their part he is evil spoken of, but on your part he is glorified. Verse 15, but let none of you suffer as a murderer, or as a thief, or as an evildoer, or as a busybody in other men's matters. Yet if any man suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him, glorify God on his behalf. This is the word from the Holy Spirit. If any Christian suffers, let him not suffer as a murderer, as an evildoer, or any other person like that, or as a thief. But if you suffer as Christians, then we should be happy. In other words, so long as suffering is a part of Christian life, we should rejoice in it. So long as we have not committed sin, so long as we have not committed crime, okay, that would make us suffer. Probably maybe you sent to prison. If you sent to prison for nothing because of the name of Christ, you should be happy. Like Paul and Silas, they were sent into the prison. They were committed into prison for preaching the gospel, for preaching the kingdom of Jesus on earth, and they were thrown into the prison yard. There they sat down there and they were singing and praying to God. And God did a miracle by shaking the walls of the prison yard, and all the shackles on their hands and their feet were loosened. And of course, the Bible says the Philippian jailer who was on duty that night thought that they had fled, and so he wanted to kill himself. But Paul told him, look, gentlemen, do not commit any crime against yourself. Do not harm yourself, for all of us are here. That you can have in the book of Acts chapter 16, verse number 25 down. You see, so what we're trying to say is that so long as we are Christians in this life, then we must pass through tribulations. We must pass through sufferings. Sometimes, if we want to talk about Paul himself, which I have to say, Paul himself, who was a very active apostle of Jesus Christ, passed through a lot of tribulations, a lot of problems in the hands of the Jews. The Bible says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 11, which I would want to read very carefully. Now, so do you understand that Paul suffered these things and he rejoiced in it because he knew that he was doing the will of God. Okay? Therefore, if somebody tells you that as a Christian you should not suffer, that person is deceiving you. He does not want you to know the truth about the kingdom. And so we read here that, yes, Paul says that he suffered these problems. Now, I read from verse 21. I speak concerning reproach, as though we had been weak. Howbeit, wherein soever any is bold, I speak foolishly, I am bold also. Are they Hebrews? So am I. Are they Israelites? So am I. Are they the seed of Abraham? So he was. Are they ministers of Christ? I speak as a fool. I am more. In labors more abundant. In stripes above measure. In prisons more frequent. In deaths often. Of the Jews, 5 times received I 40 stripes, save one. In other words, he was beaten 39 strokes, 5 times. How many of us are suffering today like that? Now he says, thrice was I beaten with rods. Once was I stoned. 3 times I suffered shipwreck. A night and a day I have been in the deep. In sojournings very often. In perils of waters, in perils of robbers, in perils of mine own countrymen, in perils by the heathen, in perils in the city, in perils in the wilderness, in perils in the sea, in perils among false brethren, in weariness and painfulness, in watchings often, in hunger and thirst, in fastings often, in cold and nakedness, besides those things that are without, that which cometh upon me daily, the care of the churches. In other words, the kingdom of God on earth, which is the church, was his primary concern. And for this, he had to suffer all of this. And he's telling us that for all of these things, he did not curse God. But sometimes today, when we pass through tribulations and suffering, we begin to curse God and begin to say a lot of things against him. Then who are you that you would reply against God? The Bible asks that question in Romans. Therefore, my viewers, we are telling us that Christians, so long as you are in this kingdom on earth, which is the church, we must pass through tribulation. We must fortify ourselves with this fact and believe that tribulation can come anytime by either the devil or anybody else, you know, for that matter. It is to try us, but the Bible says it warns that we should not suffer as evildoers. That is what we need to understand. Now, in 1 Peter chapter, in 2 Corinthians, 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 1, I want to read so you can understand that God really intends that these things would happen to us. But when it happens, we should be glad because we are doing the will of his Father who is in heaven. 1 Peter 4, verse 1, it says, for as much then as Christ had suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves likewise with the same mind. For he that had suffered in the flesh had ceased from sin. If Jesus suffered, he told his apostles, if they had done this to me, then definitely they would do it to you, because the servant is not more than the master. And so, brethren and our friends who are watching us, we are telling you that to suffer is a part of the Christian faith, and we suffer only in this kingdom here on earth, which is the church. Now, what are the few benefits of suffering? Whoever endures suffering to the end shall be saved. Matthew chapter 10, verse number 22b. Revelation chapter 2, verse number 10, the Bible tells us. Now, there is joy and happiness for every person that undergoes suffering and endures it with Jesus Christ. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse number 13, I read. But rejoice inasmuch as ye are partakers of Christ's sufferings, that when his glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy. So in other words, if you suffer, please be happy with yourself, because you are also taking part in the suffering of Jesus Christ. Number three, persecution or tribulation, produce the furtherance of the gospel of Christ, the gospel of the kingdom. That's why we say that when the church started, the apostles were persecuted, and so all of them that were fleeing away from Jerusalem were spreading the gospel of the kingdom, and that attracted people into that kingdom. Therefore, you should be happy if this happens to you. Now, there's the reward of endurance till the end. If we suffer with him, the Bible tells us that in Mark chapter 10, verse number 30. Viewers, we had been in the last few minutes talking about the misconceptions or misunderstanding about the teachings of Christ about the kingdom. The Bible teaches very plainly that while we are in this kingdom on earth, we have to pass through sufferings, we have to pass through tribulations, we have to pass through death, we have to pass through a lot of trials and temptations. And this is a part of the Christian life. And so this program is coming your way through the sponsorship of Church of Christ in Akwa Ibom State, and is broadcast every Wednesday, 6:30 to 7 p.m. with the view that you search the scriptures. When you search the scriptures, you know the truth, and this truth shall set you free. And until I come your way next week, we are asking, I am asking, that you search your scriptures and know the truth, and make sure that you study and worship with any Church of Christ closest to you. Feel very free to ask any question or comments, and don't forget also to send your questions to the numbers you see on the screen. And until that time, remain blessed while I am still your friend and brother, Goburok Etuk.
Please go back to the Bible.
Everybody.
Please go back to the Bible.
Jesus wants to speak.
Jeremiah 6:6 is the verse you ought to keep. Please, friends, let's go back to the Bible.
Jesus wants to speak.